two of the best commentators in the game, Kirk Herbstreit and Lee Corso. It's been a downpour with no signs of letting up for tonight's contest between the Florida Gators and the LSU Tigers. We're all set to bring you more exciting football as the bowl and national championship pictures start to take shape. And here come the Tigers. The Tigers are the slight underdog in this game, but there are no doubts on their sideline that they can pull it off.
Florida needs to look no further than their quarterback to figure out what holds his team together. His ability to read the defense and take what they give him is the reason they'll win this football game. He's a smart young man.
I gotta have to go with them too.
Cut. Here comes the Gators.
All right, folks, you heard the coach's pick. Now let's head down to the field for the coin toss. Jefferson steps back to pass. Has it to the senior. Can't wrap him up. Tackle at the 24. That pass play gets him roughly 3 yards. Drops back to pass. Throws this one out to the right. Eugene with the interception. He's got some blockers. He's knocked out of bounds at the 49. Not a good decision there. Why'd he even throw that pass?
Well, this is a good job by the corner of sitting back and reading the quarterback's eyes. Good job of disguising coverage as well.
This cornerback is a gamer. He comes to play every game.
Jefferson drops to throw. Steps up in the pocket. He throws left. Brought down at the 27. What did you see there, guys?
The defense was in zone coverage. The offense did a good job of protecting the quarterback, and he threw a nice ball to get the first down.
And the receiver ran a nice route to get over between the zone coverage.
Toss right side. Can he get the first? He got back to the line of scrimmage, but not much more. Hands it off. Tackle made at the 12-yard line. And that keeps the drive alive on that fourth down.
They don't have to do anything complicated. They just let their players play and play with fun.
They convert the third down with that short. Jefferson makes the handoff. And that one's incomplete. I think the kick is up. And it is good. Through one quarter, and the score is LSU 3, Florida nothing. Back to pass. He's under some heat. Get past the tackle. They bring him down. Scott gets the carry. Bounces off the would-be tackler. Look at that strike. They'll bring him down at the 49. He picked up big yardage on that run.
Oh, this is great blocking up front. Nice job of holding on to their blocks, allowing.
Jefferson drops back, looks. Jefferson zips it, has it to the senior. They convert on third and long, guys.
Well, the offense coming through in a big way that time. How about the timing on that route, Coach?
Yeah, Kirk, the quarterback was.
Jefferson will throw for it. Steps up in the pocket. That's incomplete.
Even if it's.
He gets it up, and it splits the uprights.
He had no problems splitting the uprights with that one, Kirk.
Yeah, that one looked like cake for this kid. Chalked up 3 points for the offense.
He rolls out to the left. He decides to run with it. Little shake and bake move. And he's tackled at the 34. How about that conversion?
Let me tell you something. That defense got to be a little discouraged after that play.
No question.
Gators lined up here. Tebow back to throw. Missed tackle. He throws. Found his man. He's all the way down to the 30. Back to pass. Throws this one off balance. He catches another one. And guys,
this defense really needs to step up and get some of it back.
Brought down at the six. Set up in the gun. Tebow drops back to pass. And they'll score. He stepped up and threw a touchdown pass to his wideout.
Good job of protection, and the quarterback spotted his man.
Folks, let's pause now as we've reached the end of the first half. Our score at halftime, Florida 7, LSU 6. Tebow drops back. Got it as he threw, and that one's fallen incomplete. I don't really know what this one's for. Let's find out. Scott hits it on the inside. He's tackled at the 28-yard line. Picked up big yards there, and he's going to have a first down.
Yeah, nice job there. This guy does a good job of reading his blocks and accelerating through the hole.
They'll run him again. Tackle made at the 39.
Close, close call.
They'll run for the first on third and short. To the 20, to the 10. Touchdown, LSU. Once he got into the open field, there was no looking back. What a score.
I don't think it's a stretch to say this kid could be the best running back in the country.
Well, those preseason magazines certainly knew what they were talking about when they put him on the All-American team.
Drop back to pass. Let's it go. Caught it, and the conversion is good. Over 4 minutes remaining here in the third quarter. And the score, LSU. Drops back to pass. Throws it out there. McCray with the tackle at the 39-yard line.
I talked to this receiver earlier in the week, and he comes up to me and says, "Yo, coach, you're going to be calling my number this week. I'm going to make some big plays."
Well, he wasn't lying. That was definitely a big-time play.
Rainey again. Ball being free. And they fall on the loose ball. There's a flag on the field, and I think I have a good feeling of what this might be. Scott hits it on the inside. And he hits him hard at the 43-yard line. That's not going to move the sticks.
This defense plays some sound football out there and did a good job of not letting him get into any kind of rhythm.
Tebow, back to throw. He gets the pass away. Caught. He's taken down at the 27-yard line. They picked up some yards, but it won't be enough to keep those chains moving.
They went to the right guy. He just couldn't get away.
So at the end of three quarters, it's only a one-possession game with the score, LSU 14, Florida 7. Jefferson drops to throw, lets it fly. Anderson brings him down at the 30. Nice stop by the defense.
Well, they let him catch it, but they were not going to let him get that first down.
Steps up across the middle. Oh, great. Everybody was fooled on that one.
Man, that was a good job here by the quarterback. That could have play fake as a real weapon against an aggressive defense like this.
You're right, Kirk. Those guys are swarming to where they think the ball is, then the ball is flying over their heads.
He drops back. Stepping up. Throws it to the outside. He ignores the footsteps and makes the catch. He looked like he threw that one about as hard as he could.
Now, sometimes you have to. You've got to make sure the defense can't get to it, so you put a little...
Makes a move. Peterson tackles him at the 20. Up with three receivers. Moves up in the pocket. Looking. And now he's going to improvise. McCray with the tackle at the 9-yard line. And a good decision there.
Yep, he didn't have anybody open downfield. And instead of panicking and throwing the ball into coverage.
Rainey again. He's taken down at the 1. Rainey gains around 3 yards on the run. He didn't get it. It's not even close. Well, they had to go for it. but they don't make it.
Yeah, but I like the call. They needed to do whatever they could to get back in this ballgame, too.
They hand it off. They'll bring him down at the five. Florida just took their first timeout. Tebow, back to pass. Steps up in the pocket. Throws. He snags it. Eugene with a takedown at the 43.
These days, you need a running back who can not only run the football, but who has good hands as well.
Yeah, and this kid just put his hands on display. That's a great pickup by this back.
Tebow drops to throw. Here they come. He's brought down at the 49.
The protection just broke down there.
I'll tell you, though, Kirk, it's hard to keep this end away from the quarterback.
Well, they're going to have to. Otherwise, this quarterback's going to get drilled out there.
Tebow steps back to pass. Bounces off a would-be tackler. Slings it. What a collision. What an unbelievable fourth. Drops back to pass. He's going left. And he gets the touchdown.
There it is. That's just a touchdown they've been looking for late in this fourth quarter.
Oh, my gosh. This one is coming down to the wire. It's got to be one of the best games we've seen all year.
That's the end of the fourth quarter, and we are headed to overtime. So here's the coin toss for overtime.
If I win the coin toss, I like to put my defense out there first. That way my offense knows what it has to do when they get the football.
And it also puts added pressure on the defense to make a stop if they're...
Jefferson gives it up the middle. Mark with a takedown at the 14. Picked up a first down on that carry.
Yeah, a good job up front by the offensive line. They picked up some nice blocks to allow that back to get in there for some extra yards.
Drops back to pass. He steps up, looking, looks to the end zone. He's right there for the interception. Scott brings him down at the 26-yard line. Jefferson recovers a loose ball.
Now it's simple. A field goal wins. No pressure.
Tebow options out. Brooks with a takedown. It's up. No good. He pushed it to the right. We've got a dandy here, folks. We're heading to overtime number two. He drops back. He throws the screen. Caught. The 10. Touchdown, Gators. That touchdown gives them the lead in overtime number two.
I think you'll see their defense come out on this next series with a sense of urgency. The victory can be theirs if they can get just one more stop.
There's a flag down, and here's the call.
This is what performing under pressure is all about.
You're right about that, Coach. Now it's time for somebody to step up. It's either touchdown or a loss at this point.
Jefferson steps back to pass. Green pass. And down he goes at the 16-yard line. Makes the catch, but just not enough for the first.
Yeah, they're going to come up a little bit short here. Nice job by the defense of preventing this completion from turning into a first down.
Hand off up the middle. They bust up the play and stop them on fourth down. And that's the end of this overtime thriller. Kirk, what do you think of this one?
Well, guys, I really enjoyed watching these two teams play their hearts out in this game. LSU really gave it all they had, but they just didn't have enough left in the tank once they got into overtime.
Folks, it's been a lot of fun, and I hope you can join us again next time. Our final score on this one, Florida 21, LSU 14. I'm Brad Nessler, along with Lee Corso and Kirk Herbstreit. I'd like to thank you for playing, and we'll see you next time.